Hello, everyone, and welcome back to Season 2, Vlog 1. It's already been a full year since we've last filmed our vlogs, and the series is called From the Desk of Dr. Rob Robinson. And by the way, the desk is located at Family Care Counseling Associates in Wilbraham, Massachusetts, where we have a mental health practice. And in any event, the whole series of vlogs is intended to give everyone some quick hits on some helpful information and tools that they might be able to use to make their lives better and happier. So with that, today's vlog, we're going to focus on the topic of positive psychology. And interestingly enough, positive psychology has been around for now probably a little over 15 years. And this whole new branch of psychology was actually started by a number of guys, number of people, I should say. One of them, of which was Dr. Martin Seligman from the University of Pennsylvania. And he and a bunch of his colleagues got together and asked the question, what makes people happy? And out of that question came this entire new field of positive psychology. And what they discovered in their research and their work together was that there are five or six, actually, main factors or main thrusts that help people flourish and live positive and happy lives. So what we're going to do, we're going to talk about a number of these things in the vlogs, in the coming vlogs, but today we're going to focus on the six overall things and then pick a positive emotion as the focal point for this particular vlog. So when positive psychology takes a look at, you know, what makes people happy, the six areas that they found that influence happiness the most are having a lot of positive emotion, having engagement in life, meaning that you are engaged and what they call in flow, so that you love what you're doing and you love it so much that when you're doing it, no matter what it is, you don't even notice the passage of time. And then positive relationships, meaning in life, in the sense that you feel that you have a sense of purpose in what you do, or a purpose in many of the things that you do, a sense of accomplishment, in that when you do what you do, you feel like you're accomplishing something that's important to you. And then finally, an obvious one, I think, is having good health. So our focus in future vlogs will be on some of these, but today we're going to focus on positive emotion. And for that, I think what we should look at is that, you know, we can experience emotion about the past, certainly about the present, and emotion about the future. And when you think about emotions regarding the past, oftentimes people can get stuck with negative emotions about the past, coming in the form of feeling a sense of longing for a time that's gone by, or feeling a sense of loss for situations or people that may not be there any longer, or even a sense of bitterness and depression about something that may have gone wrong. But the truth of the matter is, the past is really only here in our mind. So if we're gonna try to improve our feelings, our emotions about the past, there's two strategies that probably would work best. One is gratitude. So if you think back in your life, or you think back even over the past week, it's helpful to sit down and ask yourself, what am I thankful for? In fact, they have a gratitude exercise in positive psychology that's intended to be done once a week, or performed once a week, where you sit quietly, maybe on a Saturday or Sunday, and you think back over the previous week, and you get a journal, and you write down five things that you feel thankful for in that past week. And the research in positive psychology has demonstrated that practicing that simple gratitude exercise for a period of 6 weeks can really help improve feelings of life satisfaction and happiness. So gratitude is one way of being able to create positive emotion about the past. The second way is through forgiveness and not carrying grudges around. Grudges tend to create a lot of negative emotion. So if you notice that you're feeling bitter or upset or angry or agitated over something or someone from your past, it's best to practice forgiveness. And forgiveness is not necessarily an easy thing to do, because if you've been carrying around this negative emotion for a long time, it can become fairly embedded. However, if you remind yourself whenever these thoughts of anger or resentment come up for a past situation, take a deep breath and remind yourself that you're learning to forgive, that practice will eventually begin to dissolve some of those angry or agitated feelings and produce more positive emotion about the past. Positive emotion in the present involves two important techniques. One is the practice of kindness and performing random acts of kindness for people on a daily basis creates positive emotion in the present moment. Think about it. In order to practice acts of kindness, one has to be mindful of practicing those acts. And it really is inconsistent to feel angry and bitter and upset and negative, and then at the same time be kind. So kindness is a way of creating positive emotion about the present. The other technique is called savoring, which I also like to call being mindful or present in the present moment. So if there's something that you're doing in the present moment that you really are enjoying, try to bring your full attention into it, whatever it might be. It could be something you're looking at, something, I guess you can relate it to the major senses, something that you might be hearing, something that you might be seeing, something that you might be touching or tasting. Whatever it might be involving that sensory input, it's best to try to stop for a moment and savor those experiences. That will produce positive emotion in the present. And then positive emotion in the future involves optimism. And optimism really involves the way we think about life events and situations. And in positive psychology, they found that when something happens that's challenging, something happens that creates negative emotion, to remind yourself that it's just local to that event. It doesn't mean that everything in your life is bad, and it's just temporary. It means that the challenge that you're experiencing is just a temporary challenge, and it's not permanent. So reminding yourself of things that happen that are negative, that they're just local to the situation and temporary events, can learn to help people produce more optimistic thinking. And another tool and technique about that is a simple little exercise where you can use the same journal that you're using for your gratitude exercise, and that is being able to sit down and think about when one door may have closed in your life due to loss or an unfortunate set of circumstances, and how shortly thereafter another door may have opened, creating a more positive experience. So I hope that these tools and techniques for creating positive emotion within this branch of positive psychology will be helpful pointers in helping you flourish and live a happier, healthier life. Thanks for listening, and we'll talk to you soon.